These are literal carcinogens that are in our beauty products that we are putting on our face. And this is literally the same petroleum that goes into gas that we put in our cars. Phthalates have been linked to fertility issues. Lead is a known neurotoxin. What's up? Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Miranda and I am so excited to bring you this video because it is something that I care so much about and I feel like not enough people know about this kind of stuff. As many of you may know, I have been struggling with breakouts and acne for about 4 years. Right before my 21st birthday, I'd say, my skin started getting pretty bad. And it's progressively gotten worse. Obviously, a lot of things go into having good skin, whether it's your diet, how much water you drink, what you're using to clean your face, if you're cleaning your face, and also makeup. I can tell a noticeable difference in my skin the day after I wear makeup. It looks so much worse. So I've avoided wearing makeup and my skin has gotten better on its own, but as soon as I would put makeup on, the next day my skin would look so bad. Because of that, I started looking into ingredients in my makeup that could possibly make me break out, and I ended up going so far down this rabbit hole and ended up learning so much. So just a little quick couple of facts for you guys. The US currently bans about 30 ingredients for cosmetic purposes. However, Europe bans about 1,300. The US has not updated any of their rules surrounding cosmetic products since like 1938. Because of that, I feel like we need to take the responsibility onto ourselves and be a lot more cautious, just a lot more informed on the ingredients that could possibly be in our beauty products. Obviously, seeing that Europe bans 1,300 and the US bans 30, there are hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of ingredients that we should be looking out for and trying to avoid, but that is nearly impossible. Nobody's perfect. I've done a lot of research and I found like the top 8 most toxic ingredients that can be really truly harmful to our skin, not only in an acne standpoint, but just like a health standpoint as well. So the 8 ingredients that you should actively look out for and try to avoid at all costs. I'll do like a quick little rundown and kind of explain like what it is, what it's used for, and how it's harmful. But a lot of these products have different names they can be under. So I will actually leave a link to my Instagram down below, and I have a slide of products that we should avoid and also what they might be listed as on your ingredient list. So definitely check that out if you want to like dig deeper. Number one is phthalates. They are commonly used as a fragrance in cosmetic products because supposedly natural products may not have the best smell. Obviously everybody wants nice smelling products, so they'll use artificial fragrance. Some of those can be very, very harmful. So phthalates is used as a fragrance. It is an endocrine disruptor, which means it can affect your hormones. All of my acne is hormonal, so I need to be very, very aware of anything that is affecting my hormones. Phthalates have been linked to fertility issues, obesity, and even developmental defects, which is so freaking scary. Next is triclosan. I also hope that I'm saying all of these right. Some of these words are very long, so I'm sure I'm butchering them. This is banned in Europe. It is one of their banned ingredients. It's commonly used in like foundation, sealers, mascaras, and lip glosses. It is also a known endocrine disruptor and has been shown to have negative effects on hormones and also fertility, which is so scary. Talc is another one, which I'm sure you guys have heard of, like that one commercial that plays on the TV that's like, there's been talc in Johnson & Johnson, whatever, and it's led to ovarian cancer. Lots of beauty products still have talc in them. They're used in a lot of powder products, and they are known to cause cancer. They are a known carcinogen and they are legally put in our beauty product. The next one is parabens, which I have noticed on a lot of, especially like hair care products, that a lot of them don't use parabens, but you can still find them in a good handful of beauty products. This is used as a preservative just to extend the shelf life. It is another known endocrine disruptor and has been linked to breast cancer, low sperm count, and skin cancer. These are literal carcinogens that are in our beauty products that we are putting on our face. Imagine putting it on your lips and you are ingesting that when you eat. It's in your hair. It's your skin absorbs everything that you put on it. That's absolutely terrifying. And now that I know this, like, I just can never go back. Like, I will always pay attention to it. The next one is lead. Everybody always talks about lead paint and all of that kind of stuff and how it's super toxic. This one is in a lot of coloring and dyes, which means it is most prominent in your lipsticks or lip liners or lip glosses, any of that. That is so scary. You can literally ingest that while you're eating because you have a lipstick on your lips. Lead is a known neurotoxin and is known to affect fertility also. Like, I don't know about you guys, but as a female, like, anything affecting my fertility, I may not worry about that now, but like in the future when I choose that I want to have kids, that's terrifying. The next ingredient is butylated compounds, or they could be called like BHT or BHA. These are also used as a preservative, once again a known endocrine disruptor, and can lead to organ toxicity. It's amazing how many of these affect your hormones. Hormones affect so much of your body. It affects your weight, it affects your acne, it affects your mood, it affects so much. And that is so terrifying, that these things that we're putting on our face unknowingly can be affecting our hormones. The next one is petroleum. It is used to seal in moisture, so I believe it is maybe used in a lot of products for dry skin, or maybe like primers or something like that. And it is a known carcinogen. When your body absorbs petroleum, it cannot metabolize it. Your body does not know how to metabolize petroleum, so it just stays there. And this is literally the same petroleum that goes into gas that we put in our cars. The last one that I have written down in my notes is propylene glycol. This is commonly used as a stabilizer or a solvent, which is common in foundation and lipstick. This one I put last because it's not as toxic as the other ones, but it is extremely irritating to your skin. It's irritating for people even if they don't have sensitive skin. Like, if you're not somebody who's known to have sensitive skin, this stuff can still cause irritation, redness, breakouts, all kinds of stuff. With all of that being said, after learning about these ingredients and how harmful and scary it is to think that we could be putting it on our skin, I went through my entire makeup routine. I used the website CosDNA.com, and this is a great website. I've actually talked about it before on my channel. CosDNA.com is great. This is not sponsored by them, but basically you can search up your products. It will tell you every single ingredient that is in that product. It'll tell you how comedogenic it is. Comedogenic means just how likely it is to clog your pores and cause breakouts. There is a column for how irritating it is, and then how toxic it is on a scale of 1 to 9. It was terrifying. I have screenshots, I'll throw some up. Terrifying how much I actually did find in almost every single product that I was using. I found a lot of petroleum-based products. I found a lot of alcohol-based products, which I don't think is necessarily harmful to you, but it's really bad if you have acne-prone skin. I found a ton of synthetic fragrance in almost every single product that I had. And I found a lot of dyes and pigments. And after taking a deep dive into the coloring, it's kind of crazy like how harmful the coloring and the dyes can really be. I noticed that there's a lot of dyes in lipstick and blushes specifically, and they're really, really hard to get away from. With all of that being said, I completely trashed almost all of my makeup and went on the hunt for clean beauty products. I was really happy to find that both Sephora and Ulta had clean collections. I used Sephora's Clean by Sephora filter and Ulta's Clean Ingredients filter while searching for all of these new products. When I found one that I liked, I would take that product and cross-check it through CosDNA, and see how comedogenic it was, if it was actually safe. And then from there, if it looked like it wasn't comedogenic, it wasn't toxic, I would read reviews on it and I would try and find the best products that I could find while still being clean and non-comedogenic. I was able to put together a whole new beauty routine that I actually feel good about putting on my skin. I'm actually wearing it right now. I really love how all of the products came together and I like how they look on my face. I actually like how this looks better than my last makeup routine, which is pretty awesome. I'm pretty happy about that. I'll tell you guys really quickly what I ended up getting. I ended up finding a new SPF. I now use the Super Goop Unscreen. I got a new concealer. I found the e.l.f. Hydrating Camo Concealer, which is super affordable and was a really nice find, and it works really, really well. I also switched up my foundation for the Bare Minerals Loose Powder Foundation, which I haven't used a powder foundation in a really long time, but I really love how it ended up looking on my skin. She color matched me perfectly, which is awesome. That never happens. From there, I got all new powder products. I was using cream blushes and contours, but since I had the powder foundation, I needed to have powder, all of that. So I am now using the Kylie Cosmetics blush and bronzer, which used to be very toxic and very not good for you, but they have just switched over to a way cleaner formula and they actually are really good now, and I really like how they look on my skin. I also switched to the Ilia highlighter as well, and I am so impressed with these products. I do need to go through and still switch up my mascara, my eyebrows, and find some good lip products. I haven't checked mine. I don't know why, like when I was going through I was so concerned about like my skin. I didn't look at my lips or my eyes. So I will be doing that next. I also am about to dive deep into everything skincare and hair care and weed out everything that is toxic. I've already started that process and I found so many products that I actually love that are just so bad for you. So those are getting thrown away and replaced. And if you want to see a video on that, I will definitely make one. I hope this video was helpful to you guys, and I hope this kind of opens your eyes to just how toxic a lot of our beauty products can be. And I hope it helps you guys make safer decisions when you are shopping for these products, and we can just be healthier together. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will catch you guys in the next video. Bye!